I have been using Windows since version 2.1. Even then, it came with a bunch of built-in tools. It still does, and they're still not as great as they could be. So here are 4 free, and in my opinion, much better applications to replace native Windows accessories. Let's start with the default Windows Image Viewer, the Photos app. The best thing I can say about it is that it is free. But one of the first things I installed on any of my PCs is an alternative and free application called Earthen View. Earthen View has been around for more than 25 years and is a must-have application for millions of Windows users. It is a very capable image viewer and organizer in itself, and with the additional plugins, it gets even more powerful. Make sure to download the right version for your system. Install the program and plugins, and you're good to go. Both the core application and the plugins are completely free to use. Earthen View's main characteristics are nicely summarized on its webpage. It is amazingly compact and fast, compatible with any Windows version as of XP, available for 32 and 64-bit systems, translated into multiple languages, and simple but powerful. Even the truncated feature list includes many useful items. I use many of those almost daily, such as viewing and converting files in various formats, fast image resizing, and quick simple annotations. Here is what it looks like in real life. Starting with just viewing one of several images, I can easily flip the image horizontally or vertically, I can resize it or change the canvas size. When pressing the F12 key, the paint toolbar opens, giving me a set of tools to work with. These include a paintbrush, eraser, clone tool, color replacer, text tool, line arrow, circle, rectangle, flood fill, color picker, image straightener, and a measuring tool. While this does not really compete with professional image editing tools like Photoshop or Affinity Photo, it is a very impressive list for a small and free tool like Earthen View, and it covers 90% or even more of what non-designers really need to do. When all is done, you can save the picture in a variety of formats, including WebP. Depending on the chosen format, you can define various options in the Save dialog. Apart from editing and converting single images, Earthen View has a very powerful batch conversion and rename feature. You can manually select the files you want to manipulate or select them based on various criteria. Once selected, you can either convert, rename, or convert and rename these files in a single step. In either case, you can apply the changes to original files or create copies. For conversion, just select the desired target format and the related options. If you also want to rename them, define the pattern. And here's a tip. When defining the rename pattern, Earthen View can even use your image's EXIF information. If you frequently need to use the same pattern, then you can save those as profiles as well. The last feature I want to highlight is the integrated thumbnail view. This is great for quickly browsing through tons of images. But viewing is not all you can do here. If you right-click on one or more selected images, you get a ton of possible actions, including simple file actions like moving, copying, and renaming, but also more advanced actions, such as creating a slideshow, a panorama image, or a contact sheet. It is truly impressive. There is much more, and I strongly recommend exploring this awesome tool. Moving on from pictures to moving images. Instead of the default Windows Movies and TV app, I prefer the free alternative VLC Media Player. With more than 64 million downloads, this is clearly not just my own go-to application for consuming video and audio content. While I use VLC on Windows, it is also available on Linux, macOS, Unix, iOS, and Android. Despite being fast, powerful, and ads-free, VLC does not cost anything. They don't even ask you for your email address. With VLC, you can watch live streams as well as local content. My most common scenario is watching and reviewing videos before publishing them to YouTube. In this context, it is really handy that VLC understands the chapter markers that are set in DaVinci Resolve when rendering the video. This allows me to quickly and easily check whether they are at the right timestamps or not. As one would expect, VLC supports a ton of media formats. Their website claims it plays all formats, and while I have not tested them all, I have yet to come across one that VLC does not play. Another thing I do frequently with VLC is to convert media content. This can be a simple conversion, for example from MKV to MP4, or the extraction of a video's audio tracks only into an MP3 file, for example. Overall, VLC is fast, reliable, powerful, and of course, free. Let's switch a bit from content consumption to content creation. This brings us to another classic, Notepad++. This is a lightweight yet powerful text editor. It is completely free without ads or needing to provide any personal data. It is available for 32-bit and 64-bit Windows systems. If you prefer not to install the application, you can use the portable version of Notepad++. While its main strength is the support of various file types and programming languages, as we will see in a moment, it is also a great replacement for the native Windows Notepad. Notepad++ comes with a light and dark theme and plenty of built-in options for efficient text and code editing. As mentioned, Notepad++ supports a huge number of programming languages right out of the box. If you should still miss any, you can either check the very active community or create a user-defined language yourself. I did so for Power Query or M and for DAX myself. If you're interested, you will find a link in the description. If all this is not enough for you, you can even enhance Notepad++ with various plugins. This is a shining example of how good open source software creates an engaged community that keeps producing great value for users. Occasionally, there are days when I do not use all of the applications I mentioned so far. Not very often, but it can happen. This is not the case for the next program on my list. ShareX is a screen capture, file sharing, and productivity tool. It is another open source project, completely free, and has been around for more than 14 years. And for good reason. It is lightweight, never in your way, and always there when you need it. It has never been easier to take screenshots of a selected region, window, or screen, and share these screenshots very easily. Once you take a screenshot, you can decide what to do with it, from just copying it to your clipboard, to annotating it, to automatically uploading it to a service of your choice, shortening the URL, and copying this URL into your clipboard right away. With a couple of clicks, you are ready to annotate and share the capture as an image or a link. Due to the multitude of features, the settings may seem a bit overwhelming at first, but once you have everything set up, you can simply make a backup of your settings and will never have to go through the process again. Windows lets you define shortcuts for capturing windows or the full screen quickly, and now also provides the snipping tool for a bit more capturing flexibility. All this and much more is part of ShareX too. I cannot recommend replacing the snipping tool with ShareX highly enough. It is an absolute productivity booster. All these tools provide better and more functionalities than their native Windows counterparts. And as you've seen, they're all free. These tools should allow you to save a lot of time and become more productive. However, there is always more we can do to increase our own productivity, as you will see if you check out this growing list of productivity tools and methods. If you found this video even remotely helpful, perhaps drop a like or even subscribe to the channel. For you it's free and it does help me. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.